about 100 miles one way for me to drive to the studio. I can't do it remotely.
You are listening to Red River Radio. Stay tuned. Bird Calls is coming up in just a few moments right here on your public radio station.
I've never heard a show on the radio that people can call in and ask questions about birds.
Cliff is currently the statewide non-game ornithologist for the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department, a position he has held since 1997, and he has been an avid bird watcher for more than 30 years. He is also the first author of the book, Hummingbirds of Texas, published.
Every other month, Cliff Shackelford takes his love of birds across state lines to reach 10,000 listeners.
Cliff, thanks for joining us again for Bird Calls tonight.
Hey, Bill, happy to be here.
And he starts with a bird to spotlight.
This month is the blue jay. So we're going to talk about the blue jay for a minute. In the Red River Radio listening area, we have several species of songbirds that are predominantly blue, including the eastern bluebird, the blue grosbeak, and then to go bunting, but the blue jay is the only one here with a crest. Blue jays are so popular, they even have a Major League Baseball team named after them. How about that?
As soon as Cliff goes on the air, the phone calls start coming in, and they don't stop until the show ends.
Gail from Marshall, you're online with Cliff. What's your question?
Well, I'm thinking that I'm seeing an indigo bunting.
It's the general public calling. They're not bird watchers per se. They're just regular folks that see interesting things and they're curious about what these birds are they're seeing or behaviors. Let's listen to some that are mobbing.
So you can see how that pitch has gone up and almost the intensity has gone up.
These are birds that are mobbing a predator. And they'll do this. It's like a neighborhood watch program.
Give us a call right now.
Bird Calls airs live in most of East Texas and Louisiana and parts of Mississippi and Arkansas. The show took flight after Cliff volunteered to help with the annual fund drive.
He does this for us voluntarily, and I know it's a lot of work for him, and it's travel back and forth.
I love it. It's a one-hour show, and it goes by like a blink of an eye. It's so fast and furious, and when 1 hour is done, I'm like, it feels like we just started. I want to keep going. On the Eurasian collar dove we talked about a minute ago, he really sounds like an owl. A lot of the doves do, but this one really does, and it's just an incessant woo 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 woo. And if you hear that outside in the day and you think, what is that owl? And it won't stop. It's just this big, giant Eurasian collared dove.
He's a gem of a guy. He's as
here we go.
Friendly and approachable in person as he sounds like he is over the air.
Oh my God, look at that.
Cliff loves birds.
Look at that. Oh.
He does love birds, yeah.
I've loved birds since I was a kid, about 9 years old. My parents thought it was a phase, like picking up frogs and bringing them home. Kids outgrow that, but I never outgrew looking at birds. I just love them. I just think there's so much interesting stuff going on with birds.
Oh, look at that, flying in, boom.
A lot of people that like watching reality TV ought to turn off the TV and go outside.
Looks like it's gonna fall over at times. It's kind of fun to watch.
Because birds, there's a reality there that's so pure, so real, and so interesting, and that's really why I like birds.
You are listening to Bird Calls from Red River Radio with our resident ornithologist, Cliff Shackelford. He is with the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department, and he's been there for 30 years, and you can give us a call.
My co-producer
right now,
is Bill Beckett. Yeah, let me correct something. You said I've been with the department for 30 years, so
you've been an avid bird watcher for 30 years.
Yeah, I should. I wish I was 30 years because I could turn in my
over.
Papers. Here are my papers, I'm done, but no, I'm 19 years with the department, going strong. So he's working this big motherboard, and I just sit there and answer questions.
And we have lines open right now. We are going to go to Claire from Shreveport. Claire, you're online with Cliff. What's your question?
Hi, Hi, Cliff. Such a big fan. So glad to talk to you.
Hey, great. Thanks, Claire. What's up?
He's playing sounds that we've pre-recorded that we play on the air.
Let's listen for a minute. This is a begging northern mockingbird. And you'll notice these in the springtime. They're speckle-breasted. So mom and dad have no speckles at all on the chest, but a young bird fresh out of the nest has spots on the chest. But otherwise, he looks like a mockingbird. The tail's really stubby.
Throughout bird calls, Cliff gives helpful tips, like how to make hummingbird food.
Always 4 parts water, 1 part sugar, never any other kind of sweetener. A mistake a lot of people do is they put a feeder up and they say, I'm not going to change it until they drink it all. And that's a mistake in the hot south. You want to replace it every 3 or 4 days. So if that bothers you, just don't fill it up to the brim. Just fill it up halfway, because it kind of spoils. It's like feeding your kids sour milk.
Well, basically, it turns into alcohol, doesn't it?
Well, maybe so, and that might be appealing to some listeners, but it's not appealing to the hummingbirds, so.
As well as practical advice.
I don't think I'd stick my hand, though, on top of a monk parakeet. Boy, if they can crack a seed, just think what they could do your finger.
One more question before I let you go.
Sure.
It's a pretty good gig for Texas Parks and Wildlife, too.
This is a great partnership for Parks and Wildlife because we don't have to spend a dime on the equipment. They just send me over to preach the good word of birds through a radio station that's already established. The estimates with the radio show are reaching over 10,000 people. So I can reach a lot of people in 1 hour.
Ben from Dry Prong, you're online with Cliff. What's your question?
Rain crows.
Uh-huh.
I hear people say rain crow, and I don't know what the heck they're talking about.
Okay. Well, it's one of the few birds that sings during a rainstorm. And so in a light, gentle rainstorm, they're still making their caw, 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 caw. And that's the yellow-billed cuckoo. And that's also called the rain crow.
And Cliff, we're going to close out this program with another conservation tip. What do you have for us this week?
Yeah, on this month's conservation tip, we're going to discuss bird baths.
And with more than 600 species of birds found in Texas, many in Louisiana too, there's plenty to talk about.
The staff at the radio station think it's pretty cool that there's really that much interest in birds. And there really is.
Thank you for calling Red River Radio.
Would you like to make a pledge, or are you calling with a bird pledge?
What I'd like to see happen is that this might get syndicated.
That might have to wait. But now, Bird Calls airs monthly.
This has been Bird Calls from Red River Radio. Our producers for this show are Bill Beckett and Cliff Shackelford. The audio for tonight's program will be posted to our website in the next few hours, and you can listen to this program again online at redriverradio.org.
This project was funded in part by a grant from the Wildlife Restoration Program.